Hey everybody, welcome back. It is so good to see you. I do appreciate you stopping by and visiting me once again. This is the little continuation in this series that I put together for you guys that we've been calling the Golden Age of Pipe Smoking. And today, actually let me show you this. I'm smoking some Granger, which is one of my all-time favorite OTC blends. If you're not familiar with OTC blends, that stands for over-the-counter. And what a good segue into the topic for this video in this part of the Golden Age of Pipe Smoking. OTC, over-the-counter, meaning what type of a counter? Well, drugstore counters. Because this particular video is about a great topic, and it's going to be about the iconic American drugstore pipe. So we'll go into the rich history in a little bit, but first, I put together a little tribute, a little homage to the great icon, the American drugstore pipe, countertop pipe. Now, I want you to relax for about the next 2 minutes and 40 seconds, and I want you to grab your favorite pipe, grab your favorite blend, sit back and relax and enjoy this little tribute I put together. And then once that's over with, you're going to rejoin me in my office, and we're going to look into the rich history of the American drugstore pipe. So you stay tuned, and I'll see you in a little bit.
A white sport coat and a pink carnation. I'm all dressed up for the dance. A white sport coat and a pink carnation. Me you'd go. Now you've changed your mind, it seems. Someone else will hold my dreams. A white sport coat, and a pink carnation. You told me long ago to the prom with me you'd go. Now you've changed your mind, it seems. Someone else will hold my dreams. A white sport coat and a pink carnation.
Well, hey guys, welcome back to the office. Hope you enjoyed that little tribute video put together.
a little tribute to the iconic drugstore pipe. The American drugstore was a pretty friendly place to pipe smokers quite some time ago. Still is in some places. But wanted to begin this video by talking about the debt of gratitude that we have, that we owe to that whole generation of the whole drugstore era pipes, okay? Think about some of the people that you've known in your lifetime that introduced you to pipe smoking. Think about that grandfather you had, or dad, or that uncle that you had that smoked his Dr. Grabo, or smoked his old little rotation of K-Woodies that he had. And the commonplace that offered those old American classics was your local neighborhood drugstore. Think about where you would be had you not had that person in your life to introduce you to that. Maybe your father was smoking a classic drugstore pipe, and maybe his favorite blend was something like Prince Albert or Sir Walter Raleigh, and you grew up with that in your house. That's special fond memories for you. And for a lot of pipe smokers from that generation, from dad's generation, from, you know, old Uncle John or Uncle Mike's generation that you have in your life, their pipe smoking journey began, and for the most part stayed, with their local drugstore. Because there was a time in America where you walked into that drugstore and there's all these kids sitting on stools and everybody's drinking an ice cream soda. And you'd look behind the counter and it wouldn't be uncommon to see these beautiful tins, Brindley's mixture sitting back there. And what else? How about Edgeworth? Klan? Union Leader? Bond Street? And of course, you know, well, you know you're out there. Velvet, right? And you say hi to Sally. Hey, Sally. And put your change down for the newspaper. Sally, give me a tin of Velvet, will you? We're not that far removed from when that was. The golden age of pipe smoking, where it was a lot more normalized and it was a lot more prevalent. But I think that we owe a great deal of gratitude and debt to that American drugstore, because I think it helped to normalize it and it helped to make it accessible to everybody. I think that that special person in our life that introduced us to pipe smoking and the nostalgia and that wonderful aromatic aroma that you first smelled when you were young came most likely from your neighborhood drugstore. Unless you've got a relative that was making frequent trips or doing mail orders maybe to like Yvonne Rees in Chicago, or you know, Peretti out in Boston, or Nat Sherman in New York. Chances are, your grandfather was frequenting the local drugstore to get those old-fashioned blends. But not only that, your local drugstore has carried a nice selection, pretty decent selection, of inexpensive pipes. And if you think about working blue-collar factory workers, somebody actually brought this up in the corn cob video that I did. You look at your blue-collar workers. Your blue-collar factory workers were not able to afford a Dunhill. I'll give you an example. I did adjusted for inflation in 1950. Your average Dunhill pipe was going for about $13. $12, $13, give or take. Adjusted for inflation, that comes out to $140.96. Your average custom build was about $6. They range between $5 to $7. When you adjust for inflation, that range comes out to about $60 to $70 But your average drugstore pipe, okay, so here's your average run-of-the-mill drugstore pipe. This is an old K. Woody with the drinkless stinger inside, okay? Your old run-of-the-mill drugstore pipe that would have been on the card, as you saw in the video, that was stuck on that card, you know, on the counter, was a dollar. $1.50, dollar and a quarter. And in today's money, that comes out to about $10.84. So you have to figure somewhere between $10 and $11 is what the average drugstore pipe costs, adjusted for inflation. So I think that for a lot of your blue-collar type people, that was their best option. And that's why, to this day, if you go on eBay, if you look up estate pipes on eBay, 100 to 1, the pipes that you see on eBay are your old Medicos, your old Dr. Graybos, your old Yellow Bulls, your old K. Woodies. And they're not large pipes by no stretch. I'll give you an example. Here is, let's do this one here. Here is a custom built, okay? Here is a custom built. And really, for a custom built, it's not that big compared to some. Okay, I'll give you an example. Here's a ginormous custom built, okay? Huge. So this is not that big, okay? But here is a little Dr. Graybo. Check this out, okay? Look at the size difference. So for $1, roughly, buck and a quarter, buck 50, somewhere in there, you got yourself a fine smoking machine. And I'm telling you what, some of these old Dr. Graybos smoke incredible. These, especially these ones with the Adjust-O-Matic system, which, like a K. Woody, K. Woody's kind of loosen up a little bit, but these Adjust-O-Matics are fantastic. It's a great smoking pipe. And for $1, you got your foot in the door. So these pipes were highly affordable, I think, for your average working Joe. But then the drugstore offered even another option. Let's say you weren't making that much money. Let's say you weren't doing that financially well, okay? Back in the day, as you saw on the corn cob card, you saw all the corn cob pipes, and these were going a long time ago for 10 cents. So this was a great option for somebody that maybe didn't have a lot of pocket money. And of course, here's some others I'm sharing with you now. These are some great old drugstore era pipes. So again, K. Woody, can't mistake it. It's got that club there on the stem. And got that one. And then here, this one was actually gifted to me by none other than the Yarful Codger. He was going through his drawer and he said, "Do you have a Brylon pipe?" And I said, "I never even heard of such a thing." But Brylons were introduced by Medico. And you would have seen these advertised, stuck on those cards. Like I said, made by Medico, Brylon Bulldog, which I guess is a mixture of, I don't know, briar, maybe some other plasticky type stuff. I'm not too sure. Not a huge knowledge or a scholar guy on Brylons. And then, of course, Willard. And these were made by Dr. Graybo as well. Okay, as a introductory type pipe, an inexpensive pipe. And then we've got, here's a Graybo. And perhaps, probably the most prolific in my lifetime drugstore pipe I've ever seen is the Dr. Graybo Savoy. And the Dr. Graybo Savoy, I think growing up, the amount of times I used to look over the counter behind the cashier at a Walgreens, and you'd look down, and I'd always like to see the corn cob pipes because I really liked Popeye growing up. And when you look over the counter, I'd always see this, and you could see it right on the box, Savoy. And this is a very prolific pipe. If you go on eBay, there are just leaps and scads of Savoys out there. But the drugstore pipe itself, not only was it highly affordable then, but these pipes today, the sheer amount of them on eBay, it's a great option for smokers who are pipe smokers that are maybe thinking about getting into pipe smoking, or if you're already into pipe smoking, it's a great way to build your little 7-day rotation or your 10-day rotation, whatever you're putting together, without breaking the bank. Because eBay is absolutely flooded with these iconic American classics. Just because a pipe was inexpensive back in the day or sold behind a drugstore counter and there are tons of them on eBay doesn't mean they are bad smokers. Case in point, this little Dr. Grabo, one of the nicest smoking pipes I have. I hate to admit it. I hate to admit that it really does smoke better than some of my favorite custom builds. It pains me to say that, but it's true, guys. It is true. Some of these old classics are just so much fun and they are so cool and they smoke fantastic. It's the best thing I can say to you about them. So there's a rich history behind the old drugstore pipes. And I think looking back on my journey as a pipe smoker, I need to be grateful to that rich history because it normalized pipe smoking. It made it accessible to all of our old relatives, and it allowed them to have access to that stuff to bring it into the home that created those rich memories of that aroma. I'll give you a case in point. It had been, 2 years that I was a pipe smoker that I never thought in 10 lifetimes to give a try to Captain Black Original. But as a kid, my dad would always sit on the, floor in the living room and smoke a pipe in the wintertime and, lean up against the couch and, that aroma went into the air. And it wasn't until I started smoking Captain Black White that I was like, oh my God, that is the aroma I smelled. And it brought back a lot of memories. Where did he get that? Walgreens, or got it at the local drugstore. That's where that came from. So we owe a debt of gratitude because it made it accessible and it made it affordable and it normalized it in our lives when we were growing up. So hope you enjoyed this little history. And again, don't forget to check eBay for those old K-Woodies and those old Medicos and those old Yellow Bowls and those old Dr. Grabos. If you clean them up and you get them going, I promise you, they'll treat you right. So until next time, I'll keep working on this little series and I hope you're enjoying it so far. All right, YouTube pipe smokers, until next time, I will talk to you soon.